Let's figure out why the extra photo that we just added in did not get added into our join result set. So we're going to take a look at this query, as we've done many times, and imagine what is going on behind the scenes with the join logic. So inside the query itself, we are first saying take all the different rows from photos. So from photos right there, that's going to include all four rows inside this photos table. So we can imagine that this temporary imaginary table down here called something like photos with users is created. We're going to put all the different rows from photos inside there, including the one with the user ID of null. And then the join is going to be done. So we're going to try to mash in or kind of merge in all the different rows from users. And our kind of joining relation here, or the actual criteria for doing the join, is to find a user ID, so something in this column, equal to photos.userID, so something from this column. So we've gone through this process several times now. We'll take a look at first user ID right here. We've got a user ID of 2. That means that we would put this user right here. Next up is user with ID 3. We'd put them right there. And then finally, user with ID 1. And we'd put them right there. Next up, we get a user with ID null. Now, in this case, there is no user inside the users table with a ID value of null. So there's no match right here, nothing to match up to this row. The join that we are doing right now is one of a particular set of joins. Remember, I mentioned just a moment ago that there are several different kinds of joins. With the join that we are currently using, if there is ever a row from our source table of photos that does not match up with a row from users, then that row right there gets dropped from the overall result set. So because we could not find a match for that row, we don't see it in the final result. And that is what is happening over here right now. We do not have a match for the user, or the photo that we just added in, and so we don't see it inside of our results down here. Okay, so that kind of explains why we are not seeing that particular photo inside of our results set. But I did mention several times now that there are several different kinds of joins available to us. Let's take another pause here. When we come back in the next video, we're going to take a look at a couple of other joins, which are going to allow us to include that photo.